Hi, my name is Jack Lamar, and I'm on the ADAS processor team at Texas Instruments, and I want to welcome you to part two of our TDA2 EVM video series. In the last video, we went over some common use applications and TDA2 processor specifications. We also talked about how the features of the EVM, paired with TI's software and support ecosystem, make development faster and easier. In this video, we will unbox a new TDA2 EVM and walk you through the setup process. After watching this, you will be ready to run various demo applications and start your own ADAS system development on the powerful TDA2 platform. So let's get started. TI and Spectrum Digital have worked together to bring you this EVM along with various peripheral attachments such as a vision application board and touchscreen. In this video, we will focus on the TDA2 EVM board and its necessary setup components. Let's take a look inside the box. Upon opening, you will find the TDA2 EVM board, DC power supply adapter, JTAG adapter and 4 GB micro SD card in the same packaging. And please note that the 12-volt board power supply and USB cable are not included in the box, but will be required to run demos. With these contents, we are ready to set up the EVM in preparation for running various TDA2-based ADAS demos. The setup process begins with installing three software packages. The first is TI's latest version of Vision SDK. This can be found on ti.com. Secondly, you will need the A15 compiler found on the link shown below, and this tool needs to be installed exactly in this directory. Lastly, you will need TI's latest version of Code Composer Studio, and this is needed to load, run, and debug your system. CCS can be found in the link shown in the user guide. Now that we have the correct software installed, we can move on to the next step in the setup process. In your installed processor SDK folder, navigate to the following path: Vision SDK, build, and you will see this rules.make file. Open up this file in your favorite text editor. I'll be using Notepad++. On line 49, you need to modify this code to make sure this is TDA2XX. Now we need to set the XDC path to environmental variables. To do this, open up command prompt and type path in all caps equals, and this is where you need to type the path of the XDC tools folder. I've already copied it, so I'm going to paste, and then you need to type colon path, enter. Now the path is set. We are now ready to build the application. Inside the command prompt, go to the Vision SDK build directory and type gmake space dash s space dash j depend. When you run this command, it'll compile the application. Then you'll run the same command but without the depend, and this will finish the compiling process. Now that the application is built, we need to configure the board's Uart settings. To do this, you will need a serial communication terminal. In this video, I will be using TerraTerm. So when I open up TerraTerm on my PC, I get this window. When my EVM is powered on and connected via USB, I can select serial and the COM port will come up. Press OK, and then navigate to Setup, Serial Port. And here we need to change the baud rate to 115,200. That's the only setting that I need to change here. So everything should be matching this. And press OK, and we're ready to do UART communication. Now we are ready to load the application. In this example, we will load using the SD card method. To begin, we need to partition the SD card. For instructions on this, please view page 19 of the user guide and follow the steps shown on the screen. We also need to configure the system boot switches on the EVM board itself. To do this, please follow the instructions on the screen. Then we need to generate the Mlo image. To do this, run the command
gmake space dash s space sbl. Now that our MLO image is generated, we need to generate the app image. In the same build directory, run the command gmake space dash s space app image. This will go through another compiling process. We can now load the MLO and app image onto the SD card. To do this, go to the Vision SDK folder, binaries, and in here, the best way to find the images is just to search for them. MLO, and the top one is what we're looking for. So copy, go to your SD card folder, paste into here, and then we're going to do the same thing for the app image. So Vision SDK, binaries, app image, and the top one. And now we're all set to load the SD card into the EVM. Now that we have the SD card loaded and ready to go, we can insert it into the EVM and get ready to run our demos. To do this, open up your serial communication terminal and insert the SD card into the TDA2 EVM. You'll see when I insert mine, the terminal will start running. It will go through a process of booting up, and it will finally give you a menu of options to choose from. Right here, Vision SDK use cases. So from here, you can choose options 1 through F for specific demos that you want to run.
On behalf of Texas Instruments, I want to thank you for tuning in. We can't wait to see how you use our products to create innovative technologies that enable safer driving for years to come. Thanks for watching.